Hey guys, since we can't do this in person this year, I thought maybe we'd do something a little different and give you guys a little behind the scenes peek into how my day goes.
Hey guys, it's a few minutes after 3 a.m. and just got into the car and getting ready to head into work this morning. Always an early start.
All right, we have made it to work. It is about 3:15 now and getting ready to head on in and get the day going. A lot to get to this morning. We'll start with some forecasting here in just a few minutes and let's run through the routine.
So one of the things you guys might find a little interesting is typically I don't wear my suit and I'm not ready for work, or at least not ready for going on air. When I arrive here to work, usually still dressed in sweatpants and coat and t-shirts and things like that, and we'll get ready for on air here in just a little bit. It's a little easier to maybe not wake up the family at 3 o'clock in the morning, but let's get to forecasting.
So we start with a blank forecast sheet, and you can see pretty much on our forecast sheet we have time slices, and we'll write down all the different models, what they're saying for today. And here was Jim's from last night, so I like to keep that handy so we can kind of go off of what he forecasted compared to what I think. We try to kind of keep numbers from making huge drastic differences, especially from say one evening to the morning show. And then we start over with some looking at some maps, of course. And one thing about meteorology is it is all about the maps. I'm a huge geography nut, and when we're talking about forecasting, one of the things that we start with is just looking really high up in the atmosphere. And how high up? Well, we're talking about where the planes fly. We call that the jet stream. You may have heard that term before. And typically it just means where the winds are at 25 and 30,000 feet above us. And believe it or not, that has a pretty drastic impact sometimes on what kind of weather we're seeing. So I'll start at the highest levels of the atmosphere, and we call that 300 millibars or 300 hectopascals, but then I work my way down through and eventually get to the ground level, and that's one of the basics there of forecasting. We're trying to figure out where these little storm systems are. This happens to be one of the little storm systems. The next one we're watching is right here. So just a lot of different moving parts in the atmosphere. One of the things that I find to be extremely interesting about forecasting is what happens in Alaska, or what happens in maybe Russia, or even way out near Hawaii, can have a drastic impact on the weather that we end up seeing here in our region. So I filled in our forecast sheet. Pretty quiet day today that we're forecasting, sunny and in 60s. We are expecting maybe some more active weather possibly towards the end of next week, but that's so far out there. We'll kind of have to play that by ear as we get a little closer. Otherwise, some pretty quiet weather showing up. One of the things that, you know, we oftentimes look at, you know, showing you guys some maps, that is when we look at the weather when we're going from west to east. One of the other things that we look at that's on a horizontal plane, but we need to look as well as going up into the atmosphere. We can do that by looking at maps and looking at different levels of the atmosphere, but one of the other things we use oftentimes is what is called a skew T. And what this is doing here, I don't expect you guys to really fully grasp this, but it kind of looks like just a really confusing graph. But basically what we're doing is we're starting at the ground here, and we're taking one spot and we're going straight up into the atmosphere. So this happens to be into Carbondale, and you're looking at temperature and dew point, and we're looking for moisture. So this helps us find clouds. This helps us determine where the rain is going to be coming from, and also helps us determine, you know, maybe if there's going to be snow or where the snow is being generated in the atmosphere. Just one of the tools and the many tools that we use to help with forecasting. A little after 4 a.m. now, and just wrapping up the forecast as we speak, and getting ready to start on some graphics. So as far as forecasting goes, I'll go ahead and show you stuff really fast. a lot of the graphics that we make are automated. Not all, but some of them are automated, or at least fill in on their own. But when we're trying to make some of these maps where you talk about high pressure and having cold fronts and warm fronts and high pressure and low pressure, we make a lot of those manually. So that means that it does take some time to throw in the big blue H that you see here. And we'll go ahead and highlight that and get it all in here. It's one of the reason that we've got quiet weather is because of that big blue H. So we're going to want to highlight that. Basically, what high pressure means is we've got sinking air, and sinking air means that you don't have clouds that are going up. You think about those big stormy days and those even those summertime days where you end up with all the clouds that are building up in the atmosphere. If we've got air that's coming downwards, it just means that we're suppressing a lot of those clouds and suppressing rain as well. So oftentimes when you see that big blue H there on a map, that indicates some pretty quiet weather, oftentimes sunny weather as well, and that's one of the things that we're seeing right now. So I'm going to go ahead and get all my fronts drawn on this map, and then we'll move on to the next step. All right, pretty much have our fronts drawn now on our map. High pressure to our south and west is one of the things that we'll keep an eye on. A little weak cold front over top of us, so it means maybe just a couple degrees cooler than yesterday. Some still pretty quiet weather, though, again, in our forecast, so just not a whole lot to get to here this morning. If we switch over, we were talking about automated graphics. One of them is anytime you see projected temperatures or anything like that, you know, we don't have to go in and manually plot those. They are plotted in there automatically, essentially, but usually I go and adjust it to our forecast. Kind of, if the model sometimes doesn't match exactly my thinking, we'll go ahead and adjust some of those. So again, for what we're forecasting today, just looks like a gorgeous afternoon, and we'll continue to kind of move along here, always trying to come up with some unique things to show our viewers and show you guys at home as well, and some fun things as well, because we just like to enjoy our day and really put smiles on your face, put smiles on our face. So we'll look for some of those unique things here in just a sec. All right, it's about 4:45 now in the morning, and wrapping up some of the graphics, and of course time to get ready now, I suppose. All right, guys, one of the things that if you're ever interested in TV that you kind of got to get used to, especially as being a guy, is wearing makeup, and something that I really didn't know much about until you start being on TV. But if for no other reason, just because of the bright lights that shine on you, and it gets rid of some of the glare on you. So we're going to start putting on some makeup here. And yes, I've got a little makeup bag, and get ready to put that on and then get a suit on, and we'll be ready to rock and roll. All right, guys, we got a hit coming up here very, very shortly.
SIU is wrapping up the celebration for their fifth annual Day of Giving. The event was virtual this year. Graduates and the community helped raise money for the university. They tell us they've already surpassed last year's record. Last time we checked.
Dry weather right now, because at least we're not adding a lot more moisture, a lot more water into some of those big river basins, and there's still a lot more upstream that has to come down the Ohio River before we start to see some of those river levels come down. But checking in this morning, off to another pleasant start for this time of year. Of course, we are in the first part of March. We can sometimes get some pretty cold stuff here, of course, into the month of March, but that's not going to be the case here today. A little chilly outside as you head out the door to begin your day. Right now, we've got temple front moved through overnight. It's sitting out across parts of southeast Missouri and even into western Kentucky, but there's no clouds, there's no rain along that front. It has cool temperatures back just a couple degrees. That's really about it. Otherwise, 44 right now in Mount Vernon. We've got 47 in Harrisburg, 45 degrees at this hour in Carbondale. Now to 41 in Cape 50 at this hour in Sykeston. And looking ahead to another great afternoon to be out about just a few degrees cooler than yesterday. Winds today will actually be out of the north and east, pushing in some slightly cooler air, especially into parts of southern Illinois from this afternoon in McLeansboro up to about 59. Harrisburg, Galicia up to about 59 as well. Shawneetown also into the upper 50s, but about 61, say, towards Vienna, Anna, and over towards Marion. Mayfield up to about 60 degrees this afternoon. Martin, Tennessee into the lower 60s. And then in southeast Missouri, ranging from the lower 60s from Fredericktown to Perryville, southward to the Missouri Boot Heel Hay Time, may actually warm up to about 64 to 65 degrees this afternoon. High pressure in control. We are tracking a storm system once again moving through the desert southwest. That is a southern track storm system.
All right, we're heading into sports right now. Sports is kind of a break for a lot of us. So Dave and Evie kind of running to the bathroom, maybe trying to make sure that the shows are up to date right now as well. And for me, I'm actually starting to try to get some things loaded up to the website, make sure that we get everything uploaded there. So it's more than just going on air anymore. We have to try to make sure that we have our website updated, our apps updated. There is something always keeping us busy here. Again, it's more than just trying to make sure that everything looks pretty for you guys on television, but there's just a lot to do throughout the morning hours. Basically, from the time I walk in the door at 3:15 or so in the morning to the time we get off air, which is more so in the range of about past 7 a.m. or so, it is just nonstop go, go, go. That's pretty much it for my day. We end up having quite a few hits throughout the morning hours. Our morning show runs from about 5 a.m. to 7 a.m. and then we actually have 2 hours of cut-ins after that from 7 a.m. to 9 a.m. So in the half hours, the 5 to 5:30, 5:30 to 6, 6 to 6:30, and 6:30 to 7, there are 3 hits per half hour. For weather, so just a lot of weather jam packed in there and a lot of different hits, and again you're constantly boom boom boom, and despite being early in the morning, to me that actually makes things go very, very quickly. After we wrap up with cut-ins, pretty much we do some little basic work. I'll get into a news meeting here in just a bit and kind of help give them the forecast of what to expect today, maybe help some of our reporters if we have any weather type stories that we want to set up, help some of them move along as well. But otherwise, that's pretty much it. Love what I do, love the morning show, love our crew. Evie and Dave are just amazing to work with.